Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. I do hope you are having a lovely day. If you are interested in t-shirts, please do check out the merch store I have down in the description. So, the first sheep that was cloned was called Dolly. And today, we are simply going to do a clone effect inside of DaVinci Resolve 16. So let's get right to it and let's start cloning. Okay, so let's get started. I'll show you two couple of ways you can do this clone effect. I'll start with the very easy one. So let's, first off, we'll just make this one screen and then let's see what we have here. We have two clips. Actually, we have three clips. We have a background and then we have a clip with me with a red t-shirt on, and we have a clip with me with the blue t-shirt on, and that's what we're going to do, work with that. Okay, so first off we are going to align them, and then we're going to the inspector and we'll go down to our cropping options, which are actually right here, and then I'm just going to crop the right until the red me gets visible, and that's basically what we need to do. And then I'm just going to soften the edges a little bit, not too much. And here is that. That is the easiest way to do a clone effect I know. Of course, there is some limitation with this technique, but for a quick little shot, it'll work just fine. So of course, we can make this a little bit better. First off, we're going to highlight all of the clips, then right click, and we're going to do a new compound clip. I'll show you a little trick. I'm just going to rename this compound to clone one, and then I'm just going to go up to the effects library and I'll go to the effects or the open effects, and I'm just going to type in camera shake. So I'm going to drag the camera shake effect on, and then if I go up to the inspector and I push the open effects, I can then control my movements. So this is what it is per default. Not good, like somebody is really running. That's not what we want. So we can change the different settings here. I can add in some motion blur, and then I can change the speed scale. And if I bump that down quite a bit, as you see, it will not be as noticeable. I'm also going to do that with the motion scale. Something like that. Again, there is a lot of options to change in here, but this tutorial is not going to be about that. This is just the basic. It's super fun to play around with. So this is just how that effect is when we do a little bit of a basic thing, and it will make it look a little bit handheld. And I think that's nice. Okay, and here we have the second method, and I've just aligned these clips. So on the bottom clip, I have a clean plate. Here I have a clip of me filming. Here I have another clip of me filming, and a clip again of me with a camera. So now I'm just going to highlight all of the clips, right click, and then I'm going to make a new fusion clip. And it's just going to merge everything down here. So I'll go into fusion. And in fusion, you can see that here is my composition, nicely put, but the order of things are not like I want them to be. But first off, let's figure out what is what here. So I'm going to push number one on my keyboard, and I can see that my media in one is a background plate. And I'm just going to rename that by pushing function F2 or F2, and I'm just going to rename that node to back. Then I'm going to the second media in, I'm going to push one, and I can see that that is one of the pictures of me, and I'm going to, again, function F2 or F2 depending on Mac or PC, and I'm going to call this Klaus. And okay, in media tree, again I'm going to push the number one key on my keyboard so I can see what's in, and then again I'm going to push the function button F2 and I'm going to call this Klaus 3, and I'm just going to say okay to that. And then the last one, again push one on the keyboard, that is my top layer. I'm just going to call that again with using the function F2 or F2. I'm just going to call that Klaus 1. So we're now going to disconnect all of this nice things or the setup, because I want to do this manual. I think that is easier. So I'm just going to disconnect all of the things we have here. and I'm going to move them away from the graph here. And then I'm going to take my background and I'm going to connect that to my media out. So that is the background plate. Then I'm going to take my Klaus free layer. I'm going to put that here. I'm going to push shift and release. And I'm going to connect my Klaus 3 layer. I'm just going to make some space here. I'm going to connect that as a foreground. And there I am. What I then want to do is to take a polygon tool. I'm just going to put that here and let's make some space. So without connecting the polygon, I'm just going to draw a super quick mask here. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. I'm just going to draw a mask around this Klaus layer here. And then I'm going to take the polygon tool and I'm going to put that in as an input to the Klaus 3 layer. And as you see now, I am there and the background layer is there as well. So I'm going to do the exact same thing again, taking a merge node using the shift, taking my Klaus 2 layer. And then, you know, I'm going to connect that again as a foreground layer. And you can do that by using the second mouse button when you drag down the lines. I'm going to take down a polygon tool again, and I'm again going to draw a shape around my Klaus layer here, or my Klaus 2, like that. And then I'm just going to connect the polygon 2 to the Klaus 2 node, like that. And for now, that's fine. I am going to soften out the edges a little bit by selecting the polygon 2. And I believe you can see why. And I'm going to do the same for the polygon for the other Klaus layer here. Again, just a little with the soft edges, not too much. Then I'll start all over again by adding in a merge node. And I'm going to take the Klaus 1 node, which is going to be my front clone here. And now everything disappeared. And yes, you guessed it. I'm going to yet again go into the beginning of this clip here, around here. And yes, you guessed it. I'm going to go here to the beginning of the clip here. And I'm just going to draw a shape with the polygon tool selected. I'm just going to do a pretty basic, quick mask around myself here. I'm not thinking too much about it. I'm going to correct some stuff later, I'm pretty sure. And I'm just going to connect my mask here. And then I'm just going to connect the polygon to the Klaus node. And now you see that everything is nice, except of some small little features I need to correct, because the mask needs to be pretty tight to the Klaus 1 layer. So you can see then I can go through this, and now of course over time I am moving, so I do need to do some kind of a masking for that. And there's only one way of doing this actually, so I'm just going to highlight all of these keyframes here, as you see. Just going to make it where I want it first. There. Like that. And we're going to go over to the polygon tool here with that selected, and I am going to use keyframes for the center, the size, the rotation, X, Y, Z, and all of them. And there's only one way of doing this, and this is going to do this frame by frame, making the mask fit as we please. But you would get the basic of this. You can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to go one frame forward and then just adjust the mask to that. But let's speed this up in 80s style. Okay, and as a last touch, we're just going to feather the edges a little bit to make it look a little bit nicer. And here we have the result. And I do think it looks pretty nice, but of course we can always do more. Let's add some movements into this, go into the inspector. We're going to add a keyframe at the beginning of the timeline of the zoom, and we are also going to add that in the position, like so. So first off, we're going to add in some zoom, and we're also going to add the position to change a little bit the movement of this clip. And I do think that this give this kind of a clip a little more fun or more realistic look, at least. So anyway, that's how you do a clone effect in DaVinci Resolve. I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.